Hi, I'm Dino Bassanese, Chief Product Manager from Click4Time online scheduling software. Welcome to my video on creating and managing schedules. I want to start off by explaining some of the important concepts when working with schedules. First one, whether your services are performed by service providers or standalone resources, schedules are managed the same way. Number two, the system must have a base schedule or non-ending schedule to reference. This is the underlying schedule that has a start date but no end date. And from that, you make exceptions to your base schedule by creating short schedules to override those regular hours. Number three, the shortest a schedule can be is a week, from Sunday to Saturday. But you can create schedules that are several weeks or months in duration. And finally, the shortest schedule always takes precedence over longer ones. Let's see this in action and create some schedules. We'll start by creating a base schedule. Now, if you're creating a new service provider or standalone resource, part of that process is to set a non-ending base schedule. The other scenario would be creating a new base schedule because your regular hours will be changing in the future. For this demo, I'll work with an existing service provider whose regular hours will be changing in the future. As a side note here, service providers only have permission to manage their own schedules. In order to manage the schedules of other service providers or the standalone resources, you must be an owner, administrator, or receptionist. So starting from the Settings, Service Providers, Schedules tab, select the calendar next to the provider you want to create a schedule for. Then select Create New Schedule. Set the starting week by selecting the small calendar and choosing a date. Remember though, a schedule will always start on Sunday, so it doesn't matter what day in the week you select, the system will always choose Sunday of that week. Now because we're setting a base or a non-ending schedule, select the No End Date option. I'll walk through setting a short schedule with a start and end date later. You may also set a color for each schedule. This may come in handy if you have many schedules and want a visual reference in the annual overview, which I'll show you later. Choose Continue. Now set the available times by selecting which days are open and the from and to times. Pay attention to the AM/PM options here so you don't create an overlapping time frame, although the system will give you a warning if you do. Choose Continue. If you regularly take a break at the same time on a given day each week, you can set those times in the Unavailable Times section. If you make a mistake or want to clear all the breaks for a day, you can reset those here. Now choose Save, and you're done. After saving the schedule, you'll be taken to the Schedule section to review your changes. You can see here that there is now an additional schedule starting June 26th with no end date. Okay, let's consider that you may want to schedule time off, extend your hours during the summer, or pick up extra shifts. All those considerations can be accommodated using short schedules. We'll look at that next. So, go to Create New Schedule and set the starting week. Keep in mind, a schedule will always start on Sunday. But you may be asking, what if my schedule starts on a Wednesday or ends on a day other than Saturday? Since the schedule is a repeat of itself every week for as many weeks as you want, you would need to create a unique schedule at the beginning or end of the scheduling period. Consider a vacation April 22nd to May 21st. Well, because the first day of the vacation is midweek, you would create a schedule for the week starting April 17th and ending April 23rd, where Friday and Saturday were unavailable, and another schedule for the week starting April 24th to the week ending May 21st. You may want to assign a color here. I'm also going to add a description that will display in the column day view of the company calendar. Then next, and then save. Okay, now back up to create new schedule to set the remaining days off, where every day we're unavailable. Again, it doesn't matter which day in the week you choose. The week starting will always select Sunday's date, and the week ending will always be Saturday. Set every day as unavailable, and save. Let's have a look at what schedules we have now. In the annual overview, where it's easy to see that there's a light blue schedule starting April 3rd that never ends, a dark blue schedule that starts June 26th, and the two short schedules, April 17th to April 23rd, and another schedule, April 24th to May 21st, both in red. You can also see that as I switch between these schedules, the availability changes so you can easily reference which days and hours pertain to each schedule. Okay, let me explain how these four schedules will display. The April 3rd base schedule is in effect until it encounters either a short, temporary schedule or a new base schedule. So in our example here, we have regular hours from April 3rd onwards, but come April 17th to May 21st, the short schedules will take effect and override the base schedule. Always keep in mind that the shortest schedule always wins. Once the short schedule ends, the base or non-ending schedule resumes. Then, on June 26th, the new base schedule will take effect, permanently overriding the previous base schedule. To expand on the concept just a bit further, you can have a short schedule embedded within other short schedules. It's really not as complicated as it sounds, trust me. Consider a schedule that is 3 months in duration. Maybe it's seasonal hours. You may still want to take a week off within that period. No problem. Keeping in mind that the shortest schedule always wins, you would create the 1 week schedule with the time off, and because it is the shortest schedule compared to the 3 month and the base schedule, those hours will take effect that week. What about editing the schedules? Well, if you already have a schedule set for a period and need to make changes to those hours, you do not need to create a new schedule. You would simply go to the schedule section, select the appropriate schedule, make the adjustments, and save the changes. If a short schedule is no longer necessary, you do have the option to delete it here. There are a couple things to keep in mind about deleting schedules though. Number one, you cannot delete base schedules, those with no end dates, since they are required in order for the availability calendar to display properly. They can be edited though. And to keep the schedules list from being too long and confusing, the short schedules will be removed automatically from the schedules dropdown. Even though they no longer appear in this dropdown, they can always be accessed through the annual overview. And another really cool feature of our scheduling system is the bump feature. When creating or editing schedules, if there are appointments affected by the availability change, the system will warn you, display a list of the appointments, and allow you to cancel or bump them all with a single action, saving you from having to go to the calendar and cancel those one at a time. Clients will be set a cancellation notification stating that the appointment was canceled due to a scheduling change. And there you have it. I hope this helped your understanding of managing schedules. If you have any further questions about setting up or managing your schedules, please don't hesitate to email us at support@clickfortime.com. You may also be interested in checking out our other helpful training videos on our YouTube channel, where you can also subscribe to get all the latest updates. Thank you for taking the time to watch. We look forward to helping you grow your business. This is Dino Bassanese, Chief Product Manager from Click4Time Online Scheduling Software.